Christmas. It's so good to see all of you. And, you know, I know we're a small group, but we're here to worship, and we're here to worship together on Christmas morning. It's a meaningful morning, and I'm just glad to know that there are those of us here who want to gather and worship together. So let us begin with hymn number 93. Sing our hymn and then come on up. Angels from the realms of glory, bring your all the earth, ye who sang creation's story, now proclaim Messiah's birth. Come and worship, come and worship, worship Christ the newborn King. Shepherds in the fields abiding, watching o'er your flocks by night. God with you is new residing, yonder shines the infant light. Come and worship, come and worship, worship Christ the newborn King. Sages, leave your contemplations, brighter visions beam afar. Seek the great desire of nations, ye have seen his natal star. Come and worship, come and worship, worship Christ the newborn King. Saints before the altar bending, watching long in hope and fear. Suddenly the Lord descending, in his temple shall appear. Come and worship, come and worship, worship Christ the newborn King. One more. Right in the middle. Light of the world in grace and beauty, mirror of God's eternal face, transparent flame of love's free duty, you bring salvation to humanity.
Rejoice, people of God. The light has come into the world. Sacred mystery, we now light the candle of your nativity.
With the company of heaven and with sounds of great joy, you come to us. Now is the time of celebration and joy.
Blessed Jesus, our life and light, thank you for coming this day. Fill us with joy at your coming and make us instruments of your love. Help us to love those who love, the least, the last, and the lost. Amen. Blessed be the one, holy and living God.
Glory to God forever and ever.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you
God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, you make us glad by the yearly festival of the birth of your only Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that we, who joyfully receive him as our Redeemer, may with sure confidence behold him when he comes to be our Judge, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated for the readings.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of the messenger who announces peace, who brings good news, who announces salvation, who says to Zion, your God reigns. Listen, your sentinels lift up their voices. Together they sing for joy, for in plain sight they see the return of the Lord to Zion. Break forth together into singing, you ruins of Jerusalem, for the Lord has comforted his people. He has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord has bared his holy arm before the eyes of all the nations, and all the ends of the earth shall see the salvation of God. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Let us say together Psalm 98. Sing to the
Lord a new song. For he has done marvelous things with his right hand and his holy arm. He has won for himself the victory. The Lord has made known his victory. His righteousness has he openly shown in the sight of the nations. He remembers his mercy and faithfulness to the house of Israel. And all the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Shout with joy to the Lord, all you lands. Lift up your voice, rejoice and sing. Sing to the Lord with the harp and the voice of song, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Shout with joy before the King, the Lord. Let the sea make a noise and all that is in it, the lands and those who dwell therein. Let the rivers clap their hands, and let the hills ring out with joy before the Lord when he comes to judge the earth. In righteousness shall he judge the world and the peoples with equity.
A reading to the letter to the Hebrews. Long ago, God spoke to our ancestors in many and various ways by the prophets, but in these last days, he has spoken to us by a Son, whom he appointed heir of all things, through whom he also created the worlds. He is the reflection of God's glory and the exact imprint of God's very being, and he sustains all things by his powerful word. When he had made purification for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the Majesty on high, having become as much superior to the angels as the name he has inherited is more excellent than their heirs. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Please join us in singing hymn 94, our hymn for today.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness does not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of God, Creator, Christ, and Holy Spirit. Amen. You may be seated. So on this Christmas day, we gather together to sing some songs and to offer words of praise and to share in the language of the Eucharist. It might be tempting to just kind of throw up our hands and exclaim, words, 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 words. These are all words. And yes, you know, we could probably be a little bit more silent in our worship. But our emphasis reflects a key biblical message, and it's part of our tradition. And today, our tradition reminds us just how the Word brings comfort and joy. So you probably noticed in the Hebrew Testament passage from Isaiah that Tom read that the prophet announces peace and brings good news to the ancient people, saying, "Your God reigns." Listen, the sentinels sing for joy. And so these words of the prophet are intended to give these ancient people confidence that Yahweh will protect them and guide them in their struggle to be free. Remember, this is great news to people who have suffered from tyrannical leaders. Now, also from the Hebrew Testament, we read together Psalm 98, which is a song of celebration. I don't know about you, but as I was reading it, I was smiling. It's a song of celebration. The psalmist exclaims, "Sing to the Lord a new song. God has done marvelous things for me. Shout with joy to the Lord, all you lands. Sing to the Lord with the harp and the voice of a song." Oh, how pretty. So we read these words, and you just can't miss the poet's sense of gratitude and observation in the splendor of creation and God's protection. These are words of great joy. Now, in the New Testament passage Tom read from Paul's letter to the Hebrews, Paul describes the way God first spoke to the prophets. And then God chooses to speak through Jesus. God speaking through Jesus is an important theme in the entire Christian story. And it's a theme that's present in many scripture passages. It's interesting to note that the Apostle Paul, the prophets of the Hebrew times, and the writers of the Gospels all describe God as getting our attention by communicating with us through people, sometimes through angels, in our thoughts, in prayer, through the circumstances of our lives, and through scripture. And so we read today in the Gospel according to John something very interesting. It seemed really convoluted, didn't it? But it actually makes a very clear point. It points directly to communication from God in the type of wisdom that is Jesus Christ. So remember this opening passage? In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. No, oh, that's a lot. But biblical scholars explain that this is a poem. They explain that it's a poem of great beauty, but it also describes how God connects with us, with humanity. The idea is that God gets our attention by communicating with us through creation and nature, through the prophets like John the Baptist, and through our Savior, Jesus Christ. So it might seem kind of weird to use that word, communication, I know, in this sense, to refer to God. We talk about good communication skills, right? We talk about improving our communication with our children and with our spouse. As an employee or as an employer or as a customer, we anticipate that people will want to communicate with us. Some theologians describe the Eucharist as a mystical form of communication with God. But this passage from John's Gospel, which seems a little convoluted, actually is a great description of the way God continually reaches out to us. It's the central message of faith. It pivots on the idea that God continually engages with us through the wisdom of Jesus Christ. That's what it means, the Word made flesh. And the child, Jesus. God speaks lovingly to each one of us by reassuring us that we're not alone and offering us hope, sharing our humanity. The wisdom of Jesus shows us the way of life. And this is the message of Christmas. On this Christmas day and every single day of our lives, God is communicating with us in a way that we can understand. One of my very favorite musical movies is My Fair Lady. I just love that one. And Eliza is the central character who receives speech lessons from a very self-important and terribly insensitive professor. You might know the movie. Day after day, she learns how to speak clearly by reciting long passages and complicated tongue twisters. But then at a certain point, she becomes so furious with these speech and language drills that she just blurts out, "Words, words, words." And she continues, "Sing me no song, read me no rhyme. Don't waste my time. Show me. Don't talk of June, don't talk of fall, don't talk at all. Show me. Never do I want to hear another word. There isn't one I've never heard. Please don't explain. Show me." I love that song, yet I know words are significant, even when they confound us. And the words and the stories in the Bible might seem dry and removed from our own experience, but these words show us how God loves us. In the literal words on the page, as well as in the Word made flesh of Jesus Christ, in the very moments of our lives, God is communicating with us. God is shining a light to help us see the wonder of our lives. God is shining a light on our path to a better life. We can think of God communicating with us in some very concrete ways. Every single day, as we look into the eyes of the people we love, we see God. During the times of rest and meditation and reflection, we know God is communicating with us. In our most anxious moments at the grocery store, in our car, on the road, at our kitchen table, God is communicating with us. As we read scripture, God is communicating with us. In the moments that we spend time with people we love, God is communicating with us. When we come to that moment, when we say, "I'm sorry," God is communicating with us. On this Christmas day, this beautiful winter day, let us sing praises to God, who is always showing us how to love. Amen. Stand as you are able, and let us affirm our faith in the ancient words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Prayers of the people. We pray that the Episcopalian and all Christian churches in the world may become a presence of love and compassion within their communities.
We open our hearts to you, O God.
That those who are sick and those who mourn in our community may recognize this pain as an opportunity to accept support and grow in love.
We open our hearts to you, O Lord.
For all the homeless in this land of plenty, the poor, the mentally ill, the addicted and displaced, may they, like the Holy Family, find safe and affordable shelter.
We open our hearts to you, O God.
For the members of this community, that we may bring out the child in each other, by delighting in our differences and celebrating what unites us.
We open our hearts to you, O God.
We pray that we may give birth to the Son of God, just as Mary did, by our actions of compassion, love, and justice.
We open our hearts to you, O God.
That the Holy Spirit may guide us as we seek to heal and nurture the earth and all of its creatures with whom we are intimately connected.
We open our hearts to you, O God.
May the word of God, which has come among us today in a special way, transform us and bring us peace deep within our hearts.
We open our hearts to you, O God. Continue in our prayers, lifting up all of those who we deeply care for. This morning, we pray for Dave and Steffi. We pray for all of those individuals who are in need of warmth and shelter. All of those people who are affected by the weather, who are stranded, and who are not where they really want to be. I invite you to lift up the names of those people for whom you would like to pray, in your hearts or out loud. We pray especially for all of those for whom this is a tender time and a difficult day of the year. O Lord, our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people in the multitude of your mercies look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Creator Christ and Holy Spirit. Amen. We lift up the prayers from all of those people who offered them at the longest night service this past Wednesday. We offer these to you, O God. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all our sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen us in all goodness. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Amen. The peace of Christ be always with you. Let us greet one another. I don't know why. Maybe seated. Oh, what a beautiful, beautiful day. The sun streaming in just makes all the difference, doesn't it? It's so cold, but the sun makes it beautiful. It's great. We have no birthdays or anniversaries today. Can you believe this? No, not a one. Jesus Christ, absolutely. Thank you, Mike. Said so well. That's right, the big one. Well, so we have no personal birthdays or anniversaries, and maybe a little quiet time coming up. I'm probably not going to be in the office on Friday. We do have a wedding here on Wednesday, but we have Jim Bagnese, some of you may know from a few years ago, visited this parish for a couple of summers. He is going to be married on Wednesday in this church, so very exciting to have that wedding, a small family wedding. I have no other announcements other than to wish you all a peaceful and joyous Christmas. Are there any other? All right. Okay. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself an offering and sacrifice to God.
Our offertory hymn is number 99 in the hymn.
Over the hills and everywhere, oh.
be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Creator of heaven and earth. Because you sent your beloved Son to redeem us from sin and death and to make us heirs to him of everlasting life, that when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may without shame or fear rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
We acclaim you, Lord, glorious in power. Your mighty works reveal your wisdom and love. You formed us in your own image, giving the whole world into our care, so that in obedience to you, our Creator, we might rule and serve all your creatures. When our disobedience took us far from you, you did not abandon us to the power of death. In your mercy, you came to our help so that in seeking you, we might find you. Again and again, you called us into covenant with you, and through the prophets, you taught us to hope for salvation. You loved us so much that in the fullness of time, you sent your only Son to be our Savior, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, born of Mary. He lived as one of us, yet without sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners, freedom, to the sorrowful, joy. To fulfill your purpose, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the grave, destroyed death, and made the whole creation new. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose for us, he sent the Holy Spirit, his own first gift for those who believe, to complete his work in the world and to bring to fulfillment the sanctification of all. When the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. At supper with them, he took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." And now we celebrate this memorial of our redemption, recalling Christ's death and his ascent among the dead, proclaiming his resurrection and ascension at your right hand, awaiting his coming in glory, and offering to you from the gifts you have given us this bread and this cup. We praise you and we bless you. We praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you. And we pray to you, Lord our God. Lord, we pray that in our goodness and mercy, your Holy Spirit may descend upon us and upon these gifts, sanctifying them and showing them to be holy gifts for your holy people, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant to all who share this bread and cup that they may be one body, one spirit, a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your name. Remember, Lord, your one holy Catholic and apostolic church, redeemed by the blood of your Christ. Reveal its unity, guard its faith, and preserve it in peace. And grant that we may find our inheritance with Mary, with patriarchs, prophets, apostles, and martyrs, with Saint Aidan, and all the saints who have found favor with you in ages past. We praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through Christ and with Christ, in Christ, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty God, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia! Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
The sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us
the gifts of God for the people of God.
Body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Blood of Christ, the bread of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. 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 Body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. May God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you on this Christmas day and remain with you always.
Recessional hymn is hymn number 107.
Special day. Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Amen. Thank you, Jack. Next time.
Thank you.